This is the American Hardware Supply Kit from Walthers in their Cornerstone series. And this is how I got it from eBay. Hopefully all the pieces are here. This is my previous build of the kit. When I built this kit several years ago, I hadn't been building models for about 10 years. I had to buy all new tools and supplies, and my skills were pretty bad. So it's not a great job. So I'm gonna try and do a rebuild of it. As I remember, this is not the easiest of the Walthers kits to build, especially if you wanna do like the fancy painting, like the brickwork laid inside the concrete. I took a trip to the bad part of town and I found this building. And I'm going to use this building as inspiration for the hardware building. So I'm not going to try and copy the building, I'm just going to try and copy the general worn down appearance. And there's a lot here that's interesting. It looks like the concrete was painted at one time and the paint has peeled away. The windows have some security screens over them. A lot of the windows are broken. There's graffiti on the inside of the windows. It looks like part of the wall was painted black, probably to prevent graffiti or cover up graffiti. Some of the brick areas have been painted over with red paint, and other brick areas are still the original brick color. A lot of the concrete is cracked, some of it's falling, and some places you can see the rebar. And there are some wires kind of hanging off the building. Here are the instructions, and there's not much to it. First thing I want to do is see if I can find a way to distress the concrete, probably using a Dremel tool. I tried some different Dremel bits, and the one that seems to be the most effective for distressing the concrete seems to be the burr bit. I'm kind of using the large burr bit. So you want to use about the slowest setting that you can get. This one's a variable speed Dremel. If you go too fast, you'll melt the plastic. I was just running along the corners here and taking away the sharpness of the corners. On this piece, I did some more digging into the actual surface of the concrete here. And the problem at this point is that it looks like a piece of plastic that someone burred into with a Dremel tool. But I think I have a technique that I'm going to fix that and make it look a little better. But that was just going. And then this is the concrete support that holds the water tower. So just taking off some of the edge. On this piece, I used a cutting disc, like this here, and I cut away this piece of plastic, this piece on the column. So the plan is going to be to fill this back in with some putty. We'll see if that works. On three of these wall pieces, I did some gouging out with the Dremel to remove these columns. And on these two, I'm in the process of the next stage of filling those holes back in. And I'm using Milliput. So I'm going to try and show how I did it with this last piece. On this piece, I think I melted the plastic a little bit and it kind of bent out, so this is a sort of a two-stager, so I'm going to have to come back and revisit that. The wire in here was wire left over from my H.J. Zane mercantile kit, so I stuck it in as rebar. On these pieces, the first two pieces, I glued the wire in first and then added the putty, but it seemed like that wasn't necessary, so on this third piece, I'm just going to add the putty first. and then add the wire over top of the putty. So it doesn't take much putty. So this is an epoxy putty. I want to make sure that I don't bend out this piece too far so that it doesn't fit the rest of the walls. These are my wall pieces after the putty has dried, and I was able to carve in some cracks using dental tools, like this here. It carves out pretty easily. I have these two products from AK Interactive, and as best as I can tell, they're basically acrylic paint with some grit in them. And the concrete has a coarser grit than the asphalt. For the concrete, I think the grit is too coarse for HO scale. So I'm going to use the asphalt on these walls to add some grit to make it look like the concrete aggregate that is visible. I painted this wall section with some Tamiya gray primer just to see how it was going to look, and I think it turned out better than I was expecting. So with that, I'm going to start assembling the walls. I got the four walls together without too much trouble and attached them to the base. On some of the walls where I gouged out the plastic, I filled them with the AK Interactive concrete. I know that previously I said it was too coarse, but I didn't exactly like the way the asphalt looked, so I thought I would give the concrete a try. If you look at this building, you can see that there's entryways here. So these are at a ground floor, but there's clearly a basement because there's basement windows. So as you go in the entranceway, you need to go up some stairs. And this is about thinking about the interior. And then on the ends of the buildings here, we have some loading docks. And these are loading docks. So the loading dock on the inside needs to be at that level. And I'm going to leave these loading dock doors open. So this is what I had built for the first floor of my interior. So this was an entryway with stairs. It's pretty crude. And then it will fit in like that. So here is the dock level, and so that will be even with the loading dock. Now when this building is finished, you won't be able to see a lot of the interior detail, so I'm not putting in any interior detail, but you'll need to think about the line of sight from one window to another. Like, you don't want to be able to look in a fourth floor window and look out a third floor window. And then also inside the building, you have to think about from one side to the other on the same floor, what do you want to see and what do you want blocked. And so I decided on the first floor there's probably some kind of a central room that might be like a freight elevator or a furnace or something like that, offices, restrooms, whatever. So I'm going to block the view there. And then this column and this column are going to have like blocking windows. So you won't be able to see in. So that's some thought that I had given to building out the interior. One other aspect of the interior is that on this building you have this base strip that goes around. And so my interior, it's designed to be able to put the building over top of the interior. And so where the loading dock is, I'm going to have to fill in that base area. And then also along the sides, like here, along here, I'm going to add strips to cordon off those particular areas. So for example, if you think of this section of the building as an elevator, I want wall strips going all the way up the sides to block out this area. So when you look in these side windows, you should not be able to see any of the other windows. It's going to be its own room. I painted the building a couple different shades of brown to try and find the right color for the concrete, and I used enamel spray paint. And then I masked off the areas where I dug out the concrete, the chipped areas. And then I sprayed it with hairspray, just this kind of hairspray. And this is all part of putting on the peeling paint, the chipped paint. So the hairspray, I put that on about 45 minutes ago and let it sit. And now I'm going to airbrush the gray paint over the building and let the gray paint dry for a little bit, about an hour, 45 minutes or an hour. And then I'm going to scrub off the gray paint. Now, it's only been about 5 minutes because I was kind of afraid that I was going to have too much gray on, but I just have water and a toothbrush and I'm scrubbing off the gray paint. And I'm scrubbing fairly hard because I don't want a lot of gray and I want it to be kind of chipped. You have to kind of let the water soak a little bit. After everything dried from chipping the paint, I went through and I painted in all the red brick. I used a Tamiya Hall Red for that. And now I'm going to give it a wash of gray for some mortar in the brick so I can start weathering. Put all the windows in, but without the panes, and that was pretty tedious. That took about 3 hours, and there was a lot of scraping off the paint so that you can get a good gluing surface. On some of the spots, I just blacked over the windows with pieces of wood, and it's just something I'd seen on some buildings, so I thought I would do it here. In this case, I actually lost the window, and I couldn't find it. I also blocked out all of the basement windows on the front and on the side here. On my layout, this is actually the side that is going to be front facing. This side is going to be visible, but a little harder to see. It's at this point on most of my builds that I think it doesn't look very good, and I wonder if my paint job is going to save it. So we'll see what happens this time. I think the worn out concrete looks pretty good. I think that came out better than I hoped. The next thing to do is apply some decals and maybe paint on some graffiti. One of the features of the original building that I really wanted to recreate was the security screens that are over the windows. So for a long time I thought about what kind of material I could use to replicate those security screens. And what I came up with was these nets from Amazon.com that are used to strain almonds to make almond milk. So these are made out of nylon and it's a very fine mesh. I cut the net into window-sized pieces, and to paint it, I used this Vallejo rust wash, and then I'll come up with some way to attach it to the windows. Now the actual screens had frames on them, so I didn't really come up with a good way to do the frames, but I think it'll look okay if I just put the mesh over the windows without the frames. After I applied the decals, I used a sponge to apply the brick color over the decals to give them kind of a worn look. Other weathering I did was just some basic washes, and then I gave some very light spray of black with an airbrush, as you can see kind of in this corner. Some black over on this side. On this loading dock, I masked off this area and used a sponge to apply some yellow to indicate some added visibility for the loading dock. Here's my loading dock with the graffiti on it. For the loading dock doors, I cut them down so that they're going to be partly open. So I need to complete the assembly of this part of the building, and then I'm going to do some weathering powders and spray with some tester's doll coat, and then we'll see what kind of additional weathering it needs. After I spray with the doll coat, I will put the window panes in and start working on the roof. Gluing on the roof was a little more of a challenge than I expected, so I used strings wound up in paintbrushes to squeeze the two walls together, and then I'm gluing with Gorilla Glue from the underside. Thank you. I thought I would show how the interior works. It's just four layers, all made out of sheet plastic and I-beams. I'm not exactly sure why I painted this one tan and the rest of them gray, but the color is not really visible with the building on. So, slides in like that. For the windows, I wanted to put some graffiti on the inside of the window, and the graffiti decal from Dave's Decals did not stick to the glass panes that came with the kit. So, in one case, I put them on just sheet plastic, but I thought that looked too opaque when I put that in behind the window. So I put a decal just on acetate, and that looked better. And so I stuck it on the inside. So there's acetate, then the decal, then another layer of acetate as you look through this. And I think that looks better. Some of the windows I painted blue on the inside of the acetate because I had seen that on some warehouse buildings. And I'm not entirely sure why. Maybe they replaced windows with blue, or it has some kind of property to prevent heat from coming in. Or in some cases, I know it's just wood or plastic, not transparent. I had really wanted to be able to do broken windows, and I thought a long time about how to do broken windows. And it turns out that I can actually cut the acetate with a razor blade and get something kind of convincing. So here are two broken windows, and here's a broken window.
And all I did was just take a razor blade and very carefully cut out the acetate from the inside of the building. But this is very tedious. I wouldn't want to go through and have to do a whole lot of windows like on this building. So maybe I'll spend a little more time doing that. Okay, this building is almost done, or maybe it is done. I don't know. I haven't decided what's left to do. But it looks pretty good. It looks better than I expected. So I feel like I need to say more about the weathering because I didn't really talk much about the weathering. So after I painted the building, I used various acrylic washes, as I normally do, for the weathering, both on the concrete and in the brick. That's why I put in the brick mortar. And the problem of using acrylic washes on plastic is you tend to get a lot of water spots. And then also, there was a lot of touch-up painting on this building because of the lines between the brick and the concrete. So, to cover up the water spots and to cover up the touch-up painting, one of the things that I did was I gave it kind of an overspray, with a very light overspray of brown with an airbrush. And I also went in and did some more like touch-up washes and stuff with the different wash colors. But still, it doesn't come out perfect. So then I went to artist oils. I should say, when I first built the original building, at that stage, I was doing almost all of my weathering with artist oils. So for this one, what I did is I put the oils on a piece of paper, and I've been going around and doing kind of touch-up painting with the oils. So, like, here's some black, grab some black, and you can stick it in here and thin it out a little bit. And it blends in very nicely with the surrounding area if you wanted to, or if you want it to be less blended, you can do that as well. And you can use a makeup sponge to kind of dab some off. But it doesn't leave water spots, so that's one of the things that's kind of nice. So you can't exactly get rid of the water spots necessarily, but you can start to minimize things by coming in. So I've been going around and doing like little details, like the windowsills, just giving a little more color. Using the oil paint. See, the other thing about oil paint that is really nice is it takes about a week for it to dry. So after a day, you can come back and it looks how it's going to look when it's dry, but you can still make changes to it. So I could come back in a day and I could take some of the paint thinner and come in here and I could, you know, remove something that I thought was too dark, or I could soften some of the lines, things like that. So this is how I put in this rust area. This is supposedly, this is the rebar rusting away. So here on this window, you can see some touch-up spots. Thank you.